Okay, so we installed Tag Manager on the first video, the previous blog post. So if you're on this post and you need to know how to install Tag Manager, you can just find the link in the post, go back to the other blog post, and you'll see how to do Tag Manager. You'll see in the legacy assistant, Tag Manager is installed. And what we're going to do now is create a Google Analytics 4 account and a Universal Analytics account. So you're gonna hop into Google Analytics, analytics.google.com. You're gonna set up for the first time, and then you're gonna go and create an account. So we're gonna create a new account. New account name, Mulk Moon Test Account. We don't really care about any of this too much. You can switch all of this off if you want. Makes no difference. Then we're gonna go next. The property name is just test account. We're in South Africa, so we're gonna switch to South Africa. Important to get your time zones right. Your currency, especially if you're doing e-commerce. So we want ZAR, South African rands. Advanced options if you want to switch on Universal Analytics. So Universal Analytics you'll see here is being deprecated in 2023. At this stage, just about every Google product has switched over to using Google Analytics 4. So you can link your Google Analytics 4 account to your Google Search Console. You can link your Analytics account to Google Ads. You can link it to Google Optimize. You might still want to install Universal Analytics because in Google Optimize, some features still only work in Universal Analytics. They haven't been ported over yet. And then tools like Microsoft Clarity that has behavioral analytics, I think at this stage still only links with Universal Analytics and maybe one or two other tools. So yeah, maybe get Universal Analytics while it's still available. But definitely focus on Google Analytics 4 as this is falling away. There's no way to merge any of this data if you switch over later to Google Analytics 4, right? So you're going to be just losing it. There's no way to get the Universal Analytics data in Google Analytics 4 as it's a completely different methodology. It's no longer, looking at all the hits and stuff. Everything is an event now. So it's the same as the old Firebase system. It's like running an app. Everything, event is a page view, a click is an event. Everything is an event. So we're gonna grab the URL here, which is this guy. We're gonna go in here. Oh, we're gonna go in here. And so that is our URL. It's HTTPS. Clean that up. So yeah, don't use this. Next, small. What do we wanna do? We wanna do all of this. Ooh, let's click everything. This isn't a store or app installs, but it makes no difference. Other, it's basically a survey. Create. We want to accept. And that's it. Universal Analytics is now set up. So now we are by default in the, what were we saying? The Google Analytics 4 account, milkmanstudio.test, you can see over there. We're gonna wanna turn everything on. We're just double checking. Yes, everything is on. What is advanced settings? Yeah, no, this is all good. Site search, I think Webflow just uses query, so it'll track the searches on your site as well. We're going to save that. So, to get it installed, we're going to grab the measurement ID here. Copy that. Going to go over to Tag Manager. We're going to go to Workspace. This is the Tag Manager account we set up earlier. We're going to go to Tags, create a new tag, and we'll just call this GA4 config. Config tag. Hit the tag configure. Hit tag configuration. We want to do a configuration tag. Events will push to the configuration tag later on when we do things like track clicks on a button or form submissions, that kind of thing. We're going to go in here, add that. So that's our measurement ID. It'll be pushing to our Google Analytics 4 account. The trigger for the configuration tag is simple. It's going to be all pages. We're going to save that. And then we are pretty much set with Google Analytics 4. You can submit, publish, continue. Thing like no one's listening. Always remember to publish. So our tag is in. If we head over here now, we'll see our tag assistant is enabled. Links to all the tools you need are in the blog post. I'm going to refresh this page. Maybe hit another refresh. Might take a little while to come across. Still not there. Being particularly long. Maybe it's a caching issue. Yeah, it's definitely picking up Tag Manager. And it is installed. Sorry about that. We'll give that some time to think. In the meantime, let's go ahead and set up the rest of our property. You can use the Setup Assistant. Turn on Google Signals. We want to do this, definitely. Wait, what is this? Mark is complete. Okay. Manage Google Signals. So this is where you're getting some data from the advertising signals. We want to enable this because it gives us much more insights about our users. You'll see this is all the regions that it's happy to do it with. That's fine. And we're going to accept the collection agreement. Let's go back to Setup Assistant. So Signals is on. We haven't set up conversions. We'll do all of that later. Go to property settings. That's all good. Property access. That's all good. Data streams. That's just the stream we're getting the data from. You can have multiple ones. So measurement ID, we've already used that. Data settings. Collection. Okay. So granular location controls are on, all of that's on. Data retention. So how long do we want to keep all of this data, right? Let's make it 14 months and reset. So if the guy comes back at 9 months and hasn't cleared his cache and the cookie still in there, it'll start counting from one again. So 14 months from there. So your aggregate data does stay. It's just the unique identifiers and stuff that gets dumped after 14 months. Data filters right here. You can set up internal filters. So for example, you can set up a testing one or internal traffic. We don't need to worry about that now, but yeah, you can exclude yourself from... What did I just click? You can exclude yourself by creating a filter so that you messing around on the site doesn't count. reporting identity blended. So that's your the user ID that's generated, signals, device ID, everything to try and track him across everything. Attribution settings, you will want cross-channel data driven, so not last click, not first click. Best combination of everything. Here you can go again, link your Google Ads. We'll get into linking ads and BigQuery and stuff at a later stage. Same with Search Console. Gonna click out of that. Let's set up Universal Analytics. So we want to go to property settings first. We want to grab the tracking ID, head back over to Tag Manager, create a new tag. We're going to call this Universal Analytics Config UA config, config tag. And we're going to add that in Universal Analytics. You'll see it says, oh, there's no variable. We want to create a new variable that stores our tracking code. So UA tracking tag, whatever you want to call it. Add that in. More settings. So let's say you want to do cross-domain tracking. You've got blog.whatever.com or share or shop or anything like that. You can come in here and you can list the domains, and it can do cross domain tracking. GA4 will sort that out for you, so you'll just create a new stream on GA4, but in here you'll actually have to add that in. We're going to go ahead, we've added this, we're going to save this. It's saving, loading. So now you'll see it's filling in the variable for our tracking tag. We're going to go ahead again and save all pages. And we're going to go ahead and save. Now, if we go to variables, right, that variable that's picking up in there, you'll see user-defined variables. There's our tracking tag. That's what it's using. So you can leave all of this over here. If you're gonna start doing events, which we'll get to in another video, gonna wanna go in here and literally tick all of these on because they become very handy when we are tracking events. So see like clicks, you're gonna need the click ID or the text or the targets. There's no really quick way of doing this, but we're ticking it on now so that we can just use it in our next video. Okay, we've got all of it. So now if we go back over here, we want to submit and publish. You'll see all the changes we've just made. Again, if you're really studious about this kind of thing, you can go ahead and document everything that you've done so that if you ever want to roll back, it's really simple. You'll see what did you do and your description of what you did. Now, let's just complete this setup. So, test account. You can add an industry, which is nice. I don't know. We're just going to go with computer and electronics. For benchmarking and whatnot. Again, we want to add the advertising features. We want to use enhanced link attribution. We don't have Search Console. We'll do that in another video. We're going to save this. Then we're going to go to Property Actions Management. Again, if you want to add people, and so on. Tracking info. I don't think there's anything we need to do in here. That's just your tag. Hit refresh. Go back. Connected tags. Yeah, no, we're good to go here. data collection, you'll see you've got a lot more grays here, but let's activate signals again. Done. Of course, these things are all much more complicated for GDPR if you have to give consent and so on. We're not going to stress about that now. We'll do consent in another video. So we've saved that. Data retention, we'll see much more time here. Same thing though, reset on new activity. So the guy's 20 months in, he comes back for the first time, starts counting from month one again. User ID, much more complicated. This only works if you have a site, for example, like you're using MemberStack. You can push the user ID to the data layer, grab it as a variable, assign it as a user ID, so that when he is then, let's say, logged out on Google, but he's on his iPhone, and he logs into the site, it'll identify him as the same user logged in yesterday from his web browser on another computer. We're not going to set that up now. Maybe do a video about that in future. But I mean, at this stage, it's pretty much dead. Again, here you can add the queries like we did before. We actually didn't add it, but you can go ahead and add it there. And then there's no BigQuery linking for Universal Analytics. Like I said, just Search Console. So now let's go see if there's anything else we want to do here. We'll get to goals when we do conversions and so on. There's nothing else we need to do here. Yes, okay, we can get rid of this warning about Universal Analytics. Let's go to Home and Real Time. We're going to go try and see if this is working. Overview. Oh, there we are. One person logging in from Swellendam, South Africa. The tracking code has started working. If we use the legacy assistant here now, we'll see Google Analytics. Universal Analytics is installed. There's our tracking ID. There's our tag manager ID. There is global site tracking. And now, if we go back into Analytics, we'll see that we're browsing the site. Let's switch over to the GA4 test account. It's loading. Reports, real time. This guy seems to be, here we go. That was us. We can refresh over here. Click around a bit, send some signals to the site, and you can see there's our first page view and everything. If we do something, let's go in here. We're gonna say record. I'm gonna restart this page. Click. There's a button, fill in a form, test, I send. Oh, that's my email address. Fine, you all can mail me. Ooh, milkmoonstudio.com. Send a message. And we're just gonna, let's go to the 404. We've got the tracking code installed on there as well. Yes, it's picking it up. So now if we stop the recording, we can go to full report here. We can see everything that happened on the site. So what it was sending where. And now,
someone was detected at your gate.
Oh, my computer is saying someone was detected at the gate, Alexa. Anyway, GA4 seems to be working just fine now. You can see all the events pouring in. That's it. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. and we'll try and help you out. Cheers.